Hi everyone, my name is Michael and I'm going to show you the installation of the Paessler PRTG Data Hub. I'm a software developer working on the Data Hub, so if you have any questions later on, just drop them in the comments. What is the Data Hub? The Data Hub is a network messaging relay with forwarding functionalities. You can filter and split the network messages coming in and going out. So yes, everything you see today is also be written down in the manual. So if you have, if you prefer the written down version of that, have a look there. So to install the PRTG Data Hub, what do we need? We need a Linux system running the latest Debian or Ubuntu, so Debian 12 or Ubuntu 24.04 on any AMD 64 machine. That can also be a virtual machine. For disk space, we require 50 MB and two cores should be on the system and also around about 512 MB of RAM. To install anything on the system, you need to have a root access, a license key from us, which you can, request a trial license if you want, and we will configure some PRTG sensors, so make sure you have your PRTG already installed and available. Okay, what we are going to do, we are installing the latest stable version of the Data Hub. To do that, we need to add the official Paessler repository to the system to get updates and have an easy install flow. For this, you can also have a look in the manual. That's the same command that just adds our public key to your machine so that everything is signed from us and you know that the packages are actually from us. The next step is to add the actual repository where you can get the packages from. Also, again, you don't have to type this. You can find it in the manual. Okay. So now we added it. Let's do a sudo apt update so that apt recognizes the new repository. Perfect. And let's do apt search Paessler Data Hub. Okay. So now we're doing the actual installation with sudo apt install Paessler Data Hub. And here we have this little configuration wizard with Debian packages, and you need to provide your license key for the Data Hub to run. Now we're going to create a user management user. That user is only for managing and administrating users. So be creative. No, don't. Please don't. But put in a username you can remember and also a password you do remember, because we need it later on. This prompt hints you can add the operational role, so everything you can do with the Data Hub, access metrics, retrieve configuration and so on, also via the endpoint, but it is better to keep the users separated, so have one user for user management and one for the operational user. If you know you just want to try it out and have a quick look, you can add this operational role to the user, but I advise against it, so we don't do it here. Perfect. Everything is installed. If you have any problem or need a reinstallation instead of just removing and editing the package again, you can do a sudo dbk reconfigure Paessler Data Hub, and then the prompts will come again. So if you made a mistake by entering your license or so on, this can be triggered here again. For now, I don't want to add another user for that, because the user database is kept in place and is not altered. So you cannot add the same user twice. So I do not enter anything, so it won't create a new user in this step, as you can see also in the command line output. Okay, perfect. We have this. And now let's see if the service is actually running. This is a system service under Linux, so just the usual systemctl status. Paessler Data Hub service. Perfect. And as we can see, it is active and running, and no rule has been started and loaded yet. Perfect. This is what we expected. But before we dive in the actual configuration, let's see what is on the system now. The first folder I'm going to show you is the var, the variable optional folder, var opt Paessler Data Hub. This is where the user database is stored. So it just contains the current user we added during our installation and also activation files that are kept. Exactly. And what else do we need? I show you where the actual binary is located. This is under opt because optional packages, Paessler Data Hub. As you can see, there is the Data Hub binary. We have a doc folder and the third-party licenses in the doc folder. This is also very important. You have the examples. The examples are just a template you can, or just have some inspiration on what you can do with the Data Hub. Just have a look there if you have any questions about the configuration files. Okay, so now let's have a look at the actual configuration. This is located at etc, Paessler Data Hub. There are two folders in one file. The certificate store is for if you require syslog TLS or syslog VR mutual TLS. The rules configuration folder and the config YAML that stores the overall configuration for the PRTG Data Hub. So we are going to have a peek in the config file just to have a look how it looks like. Usually you don't have to alter anything because it comes quite good pre-configured. One thing I want to show you here is if you want to have some file logging, for example, you can switch a file level to info, for example, and everything info or more severe will be logged to a file at the located path. Okay. So now everything is up and running. I showed you the configuration files. We are going to have a look at the endpoint. The Paessler Data Hub is starting. This is important because everything else, you do not need to touch the system any further. It's just going via the endpoint, the Spagger UI we have. Because right now I did not configure any certificates, it will always create one with a self-signed certificate, so I have to trust it in my browser. I know the risk. And here I have to enter the credentials of the user we just created, the user management user. And let's see if that works. Let's see how many users are there. We expect to have one exactly. I get a response of 200 and it's showing the Data Hub user with the user management role. Of course, you can do it also via the curl command or widget or any other tools that's out there to do some HTTP requests. What we are going to do is to create a new user. And I just altered the password a little bit. And this time make sure to have the operational rule as it's shown here in this example already added to the user. And if it worked, yes, we got a 201 response. That means the resource was created. To make sure that actually works, we are going to log out here and log in with the new user. And let's see if we can request the system metrics now. Yes, we can. Have a look, quick look. We see the process. The process is currently using almost no CPU load and has a little bit of RAM. This is in bytes, so don't worry. And this is the runtime, how long the process is already up in seconds. For the other metrics that are in there, we do not have any rules configured yet, so there will be no traffic recorded. Everything is zeroed out. Okay. And now we're going to switch to PRTG to monitor our Data Hub from PRTG. And for that, I create a new group first under the local probe, call it PRTG Data Hub group. And I will add in the credentials section, credentials for the PRTG Data Hub. This will be the operational user. And create the group. Perfect, now we have the group. Now I want to add a new device. This will be the Data Hub. Create that one. And when this one is added, I create the first Data Hub sensor. Make sure you have the beta sensor flag enabled in your configuration. As of now, the sensors are in beta status, but they will soon be won't be require the beta flag anymore. Okay. I just create a process sensor to see how the process metrics of the data hub are. And I just want to create a new sensor. Another one, also for the data hub, monitoring the traffic, the overall traffic that's going through the data hub. As you can see, it's already green, perfect. And here you have the same metrics as I showed you in the Swagger UI. This is the uptime, memory consumption, usage, and CPU usage. Basically nothing because we don't do anything yet. Okay, so, and we have the data hub traffic sensor, which also shows the metrics right now. As we do not have any rules configured yet, there is no traffic, same as in the Swagger endpoint shown before. What comes next? After you install something, of course, you want to know how to remove it again. For that, you can just do sudo apt remove Paessler data hub. This will remove not everything. The user met database and also your configured rules won't be deleted. So if you want to make sure everything is really, really purged from the system, use sudo apt purge and everything will be cleaned for you. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If so, feel free to leave us a like and consider subscribing. If there's a topic you want us to make a tutorial about, you can tell us in the comments. If you still have questions, also leave a comment or even better, a support ticket. Have a nice day and thanks for watching.